Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja, Basement Waterproofing Ninja. I want to share with all of you one of the ways we install sump pump basins in basements and crawl spaces that is different from our competitors. Don't tell them. Stay tuned. Okay, so one of the biggest problems a lot of homeowners face is they're taking on foundation water, and normally that foundation water comes through where the block or concrete wall meets the footer. Okay, it's called the cove. We call it the cove. That's probably the number one place that you're taking on water in your basement or your crawl space, okay? So one of the things that we do to ensure that we're getting maximum efficiency of our water management or waterproofing system is to properly install the basin. A lot of people don't put a lot of time and thought into this, but look at how this basin and most basins out there are designed. They actually have these little holes in them. Now, the holes are designed for the water to go in, but guess what? It also, depending on what kind of soil you have, can allow mud and sand and different things like that to enter the basin. So tip number one, and one of the things that we do that's different from a lot of our competitors is we'll actually put a felt liner around the basin in order to filter and keep that silt out. And that improves the efficiency and the effectiveness of the sump pump that we install in the basin. Keep in mind, our sump pump moves about 4,800 gallons per hour of water. And another tip that we encourage homeowners to do is also to put a basin and a sump pump about every 140 linear feet. It just creates a more efficient waterproofing system inside the home, whether it's a basement or a crawl space. Back to what I was talking about. The other thing that we do that we don't see a lot of contractors do is we actually directly plug our waterproofing pipe, whether it's the hydroway or the NDS Easy Flow, directly into the basin. Okay, a lot of people, they'll stop the pipe right about here. They'll have a lot of gravel around the basin. Remember, they don't put felt on it. So that gravel and that soil eventually is going to make its way into here. What we do is we'll put a direct link, we'll cut a hole and put the pipe directly into the basin on all sides. That so if you got the pipe coming this direction, it's going directly into the basin. Pipe coming this direction, going directly into the basin. That way it causes all that water in that pipe to make its way into the basin so that, again, we're getting as much water out of that pipe into the basin so that that 4,800 gallon per hour sump pump can pump all that water out of your basement and your crawl space. Those are two of the things that we do that's different than many of the contractors. So if you think about hiring someone else versus us, just, you know, think about how we install our basins to keep the sump pump clean and the water flowing as quickly as possible to get it out of your basement or your crawl space. I'm Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja, Basement Waterproofing Ninja. Hope you make it a happy and blessed day. We'll see you later.